Mark and Rose Stevens underwent a puzzling career change nearly 15 years ago. Mark, an over-the-road trucker, turned off the keys and turned on the punch press. Peacetime Puzzles was born. Rose, who worked for Liberty Mutual, turned in her corporate card and started putting together the pieces of a one-of-a-kind business in Northwood, catering to people like themselves.
People that are, we might call the baby boomers, people that are trying to slow down, they want to have some time to relax. You have the people on vacation, they find puzzles are a fun thing to do where there's no TVs or computers, and there's that group. There's the people that are just traveling through and want some kind of remembrance of where they've been. There's the people that just want to do something fun as a group or by themselves.
It was a puzzling fascination with puzzles that led this couple to believe this was a match made in a puzzle. First peddling puzzles in a 10 by 10 tent at area craft shows, eventually this red barn with a puzzling logo on the top along Route 4 would stand as the puzzle headquarters of the Northeast.
We buy from other manufacturers from all over the world, so we have that group of puzzles, and they vary in number of pieces from, say, 30 to, our biggest one is 18,000 pieces. We have our own line of puzzles from local artists and photographers. We make in a variety of sizes. We have the vintage puzzles are ones that are puzzles we've been collected for years, and we now have done them, taken pictures of them, and they're for sale for people that collect them or like the image or the style, or they go back into the 30s up to the current years.
While customers browse the collection up front, Mark is busy with production in the back. They can make a puzzle out of any image you have.
Either email it to us, or if it's a print, bring it in to us and we can scan it. We scan it into Photoshop where we blow up the picture. Rose does that, and we print out on the large scale Epson printers, the large format printers. Most pictures blow up pretty well to the 20 by 28 inch 1,000 piece puzzle size. And we mount the print on chipboard, it's called. And it's cut on a die cutter. It's like a big cookie cutter, it goes through a roller press, and it's forced down into the cutters, which cuts it into 500 pieces or 1,000 pieces. And you put it in a box and off it goes.
The complexity and sizes are as varied as the pictures themselves. They run on average from $25 to $50, and wow, what a great idea for a gift.
That's our largest market for the custom work that we do is family, family pictures of either old pictures or current pictures to send to grandparents. Starting at a 10 by 13 and 100 piece, we go to 13 by 19 in several sizes, 30 big pieces, 175 pieces, 300 pieces, and we go to 18 by 24 in a 500 piece puzzle, and then 20 by 28 in a 1,000 piece puzzle.
It's also local artists and photographers who take their works of art and can now offer them as puzzles. It's collectors who are looking for a special attachment to the past.
Oh, sometimes it's a glimpse of their youth, something they remember from the past. Other collectors, like vehicle collectors, they'll collect a particular type of puzzle or a puzzle of a particular movie. They might collect Gone with the Wind things or something. So,
and for puzzle fanatics, there's a trade-in section. That's right, unload all those puzzles collecting dust in the closet. But please, only puzzles with all the pieces.
They're the more current used puzzles. People who do lots of puzzles, people who like puzzles, tend to do lots of them. And so we take them in trade. It started as just kind of a convenience for our regular customers. They end up with closets full, so we allow a little bit of money against the next purchase, and it keeps the older ones in circulation, which is fun.
They offer puzzling options other than the ordinary piece-by-piece puzzle.
The metal tavern puzzles are fun. They take them apart, put them together in varying degrees of difficulty.
We also do things with books. We have crossword puzzles, mazes, mind-blowing puzzles.
Granny angry that the puzzle's been on the dining room table too long and turkey dinner is approaching? No problem.
We have these rolls where you can do the puzzle on it, but if you have to stop in the middle of it, you can just roll up your puzzle pieces and later on take it back out. We also have people that will put a tablecloth right on top of the puzzle. So that's not an excuse not to do puzzles. If you need the dining room table, we can work with you to get different options for you.
So this is the place to find the piece to the puzzle that has eluded you for so many years. If you're not a puzzle person, but know someone who is, take this advice.
They're usually buying a gift for somebody else that they think likes to do puzzles. It's never for themselves. It's a thing they like to do puzzles, so we should get them something really hard. And those are the ones we often get back in trade-ins too that are unopened. So just a word to the wise.